Hare Krishna. So we are here in this very, very auspicious and beautiful place of Sri Govardhan Dham. Sri Govardhan Dham ki
jai!
So here, this place where we are sitting, this town is known as the Govardhan town, and Govardhan is one of the, as we were hearing in past 2-3 days, that when Krishna was coming to this material world, he requested Srimati Radharani to follow. So उन्होंने राधा जी से निवेदन किया था कि उनके साथ आए. तब राधा रानी ने कहा कि मैं आऊंगी एक शर्त पर, अगर तीन चीजें, तीन व्यक्ति हमारे साथ आएंगे. एक है वृंदावन, यमुना और गोवर्धन. सो देर इज अ ब्यूटिफुल पास्ट टाइम ऑफ द अपियरेंस ऑफ गोवर्धन इन द स्पिरिचुअल वर्ल्ड. एक बार राधा और कृष्ण नित्य लीला में थे गोलोक वृंदावन में, एंड राधा जी ने कृष्ण को कहा कि आप मेरे लिए एक ऐसी जगह बनाइए जहां हमारी लीलाओं को और प्रोत्साहन मिलेगा. देयर विल बी मोर एनकरेजमेंट ओवर पास्ट टाइम. सो कृष्ण आउट ऑफ द डिजायर टू सेटिस्फाई हिज बिलोवेड, he very strongly desired, and that desire to make such a place came in the form of a seed, and that seed was planted on the ground of Golok Vrindavan in the spiritual world. And as soon as that seed was planted, that seed grew to a big and beautiful mountain known as the Govardhan mountain. So that is the origin of Govardhan in the spiritual world. That it was created so that Radha and Krishna can have more and more pastimes being performed. They can have a private place for them.
Somebody's mobile is disturbing the.
So they can have a place where they can perform their pastimes of meeting, union, death, in a beautiful way. So when they were supposed to come here, Srimati Radharani requested that Govardhan should be brought back to this planet. For every pastime which happens here, the origin is already there in the spiritual world. So how Govardhan came to this land of this particular area, there is a pastime. Govardhan was there in one of the. Govardhan later realized that Krishna is going to soon come, so he wanted to assist in the pastimes of the Lord. So he was already, he had come in Satyuga in one of the Dvipa planets, and that is where Pulatsya Muni, he saw this beautiful mountain and he desired that I want to carry the mountain with me. So Govardhan's he requested Dronachal, the father of Govardhan, that I want this mountain. and Dronacharya accepted. So while he was carrying, Govardhan, being an expansion of the Lord himself, he realized when they came to hear. Oh, sorry, I missed the pastime. Govardhan requested Tulitha Muni that I will come only on one condition, that if you, wherever you keep me, I will not move from that place. Means you can lift me once, but you can only keep me once. Once you keep me, you cannot pick me up again. So when they were coming to this tract of land, by a mysterious potency, Tulitha Muni had an urge for nature's call. Now he is a Muni. A Muni can control all his senses very, very nicely. There is no need for Tulitha Muni to stop. But that is a whole mystery of Krishna's pastime. He is Yogeshwar. For a yogi and Muni also, when a yogi and Muni, however expert he may be, but when he wants to, Krishna wants to do some pastime, that yogi or Muni will forget his power. So Tulitha Muni, although he could have actually carried Govardhan wherever he wanted, the moment Govardhan, when Tulitha Muni was flying with Govardhan in this area, at that time, Govardhan realized that my Lord Krishna is going to come here, and therefore to assist in his pastimes, I have to be here. And immediately at that time, he had a nature's call, so he kept Govardhan. And the moment he kept Govardhan, after that he attended nature's call, but Govardhan would not move. So Tulitha Muni cursed him, cursed Govardhan, that because you are not now moving, I curse you that every day you will become smaller by the size of a mustard seed. So jo rai ka dana hota na, you will become smaller than that. That also Govardhan understood that this is not a curse. Because in Kali Yuga, for Krishna to perform pastimes, I cannot be so tall. This Govardhan was very, very tall. It is said that it was 80 miles high. 80 miles. सस्ते नील मतलब लगभग 160 किलोमीटर 150 किलोमीटर का ऊंचा. बट बिकॉज ऑफ द कर बाय द टाइम इट वॉज कलियुगा ही इज नाउ मैनेजेबल फ्रॉम कलियुगा पर्सपेक्टिव. सो दिस वॉज गवर्नमेंट कॉन्शियसनेस दैट यस दिस कर्स ऑल्सो इज लाइक अ ब्लेसिंग. सो गोवर्धन एक्चुअली इज वन ऑफ द एक्सपेंशन ऑफ द लॉर्ड. ही इज द लॉर्ड हिमसेल्फ. Devotees worship him as the Lord. It is Krishna himself who is Govardhan. But this Krishna is in the mood of a devotee. So one of the titles given to Govardhan is Haridasa Varya. Haridasa Varya matlab Bhakta me Sarvashrestha, the best of devotees. Now who is called as the best of devotees? Since 2-3 days we have been hearing about Lord Chaitanya. The best of a devotee is that devotee who is willing to take all sorts of inconvenience for the sake of convenience for the Lord. That is the best of the devotee. Normally in the material world we feel that only if I get some sense of security, some pleasure, then only I will be happy. That is the concept of our life here. Ki ye sab maine kiya to mera sukh badhega. We don't have an experience of actually living with inconvenience for the pleasure of someone and then deriving joy. That we don't have an experience because we have never done it in our life. If we have taken inconvenience for someone, then that has had to do something with us. Like it is very easy for all of us to take inconvenience for our own friends or family people. Everybody does that. Even the storks who you see here, they are actually fishing for their babies who will not be flying somewhere, wherever they have laid their eggs. So every animal takes care of the family. So taking challenges and inconvenience only for the sake of connections with the body is not actually a part of a service. Although there is service involved, it's not part of a pure service. So Haridasa Varya means those devotees or who only for the exclusive pleasure of the Lord they are willing to go undergo any amount of difficulty or challenge. So what does Govardhan do in the pastimes of Krishna? Govardhan assists the Lord
by his beautiful presence. Because of so many trees and it's a beautiful jungle, big jungle, because of that rainfall timely, he provides unlimited fruits, different kinds of juices to the Gwalbas, the Gopas and the Gopis. He provides good shed, he provides good beautiful flowers for the sake of the service of the Lord. Govardhan provides nice fresh water. During rainy season, Govardhan provides with beautiful streams of water which flow from the Govardhan, seeing which the cowherd boys become very happy. When they are in fatigue, they wash their feet in those waters, they drink those waters, they bathe in those waters. So these are the various pastimes. With the beautiful soft grass which Govardhan has, he provides a good sitting place. Like when we come here, somebody has created this beautiful ambience, this beautiful ghat, because of which we are getting such a beautiful experience. That person may not be there, but his attitude can be seen by just the beauty of what is here, that oh, he really wanted to present something wonderful. So similarly, Govardhan may not be in a talking form as a mountain, but he is in the mood of exemplary service, and therefore he provides a beautiful ambience for the pastimes of Radha and Krishna to naturally come out, to assist to him. The demons, they also provide an ambience for pastimes of the Lord, but in a different way. That is not Anukulyanu Krishnanu, which we were discussing yesterday. Service means that which is convenient for the Lord. Anyways, we have to serve. Whether you are living a purely material life or a spiritual life, you have to serve. So devotee always tries to see that, let me see that what is the best convenient fashion I can serve, the Lord. So he is always meditating, what can I do to create this? And in Govardhan also he provides with many, many kunja or bushes where Radha and Krishna can perform different kinds of intimate pastimes and so many other things. He provides an unlimited number of lakes which give a soothing experience to them. So this is the glory of Govardhan, that he is although he is Krishna himself, he is in the mood of a servant and the exemplary servant here. So here typically at this place, we are here at Kusum Sarovar. It is mentioned that Srimati Radharani Krishna would actually, Srimati Radharani would pluck some flowers in the nearby area, therefore it was called Kusum One. So therefore it is Kusum Sarovar. And Krishna would braid Srimati Radharani's hair. Wo Radhaji ka baal banate the na. So this is that area. Also there is a pastime of Sanatan Goswami. One time a rich merchant had come to Sanatan Goswami and So there was a rich merchant. He came to know that Sanatan Goswami has a very special jewel with him, and which with that touchstone, if you touch anything, it becomes gold. So he was very interested in that. So this person came to meet Sanatan Goswami and he requested him that, I want a blessing from you. He said, you ask. He said, I want that touchstone which you have, which I have heard, which converts things to gold. So Sanatan Goswami, immediately there was a pile of rubbish, garbage nearby. He said, it is just lying in the garbage somewhere, you can check it. So this man went there and he searched in the garbage with all his creativity, intelligence and hard work. And he found this touchstone, beautiful. And he took it, he thanked Sanatan Goswami and started walking. Meanwhile, on the way he realized that if Sanatan Goswami had this touchstone here lying in this garbage, that means he must be having something more precious
जिसके घर में जिसके पास चिंतामणि ही कचरे के डब्बे में हो, मतलब उसके पास और भी कुछ होगा विशेष, तो ये हमें अगेन वेंट टू सनातन गोस्वामी एंड रिक्वेस्ट कि मुझे वो चीज चाहिए जिसके आप जो आपके पास है कि आपने चिंतामणि को भी कचरे में डाल के रखा हो। तो सनातन गोस्वामी सेड आई विल टेल यू दैट थिंग ओनली ऑन वन कंडीशन, ओनली इफ यू थ्रो दिस, गो एंड थ्रो दिस स्टोन। So it is explained that some places it is explained that that stone was thrown over here, and in some places it is explained it was thrown in the Yamuna. Although the waters of Kusum Sarovar and Yamuna are also non-different. Yes. So they say that that stone was thrown somewhere here. So after throwing that stone here, he came to meet Sanatan Goswami, and Sanatan Goswami said, "I have something more precious than this jewel, and this is the holy name." Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And that's when he gave the touchstone of the holy name, which converts our heart, which is like a stone heart, into a beautiful place for the service of the Lord. So that stone was thrown over here, and the man who received the Mahamantra, he was so grateful to Sanatan Goswami. He became a great devotee of the Lord later. He did not feel sorry. Kare yaar, ek mantra ke liye tha. That was not his mood. Otherwise, in Kali Yuga, nowadays if somebody comes to know, he will take the mantra and dive and take the stone also back. Not like that. There was a genuine appreciation for a person who is willing to throw a touchstone for the holy name. So people, devotees generally, many people take bath, they perform, they dip here. Of course, I don't know how many of you are willing. But so there are so many such pastimes which take place here. Nearby there is Uddhav temple, then there is Narad one, they are all just here nearby. All the great personalities whom you hear in the Bhagavatam, all of them are residing here and doing menial service in this place. So various places will be speaking about various pastimes. It is explained in our scripture that when you cannot personally even visit all the holy places, just by performing parikrama, you actually get the benefit of visiting all those places. And therefore people do Govardhan parikrama. And so we will also be doing Govardhan parikrama. Our acharyas recommend that one should do parikrama bare feet. One should not wear any chappal. Unless and until somebody has serious problems. Hamare acharyas ne kaha hai ki parikrama chappalon ke bina nange paav karni chahiye. Aur aap yahan dekhenge parikrama karte waqt ki kuch log aise dandavat parikrama karte hain. हम लोग जो चल के करेंगे, कुछ लोग दंडवत करके करते हैं, दंडवत करते हैं, खड़े होते हैं, वापस दंडवत करते हैं, और कुछ लोग 108 दंडवत परिक्रमा करते हैं, मतलब एक जगह पर 108 दंडवत करते हैं, फिर आगे खड़े होते हैं, फिर 108 दंडवत, फिर आगे, वैसे मतलब 3-4 महीना परिक्रमा चलता है उनका। तो हमारी परिक्रमा केवल पैरों से है चल के, जो लोग चल नहीं पाएंगे उनके लिए साइकिल रिक्शा वो सब है, वो आप अपने हिसाब से देख लीजिए। बीच बीच में अलग अलग जगह पर कथाएं होंगी तो हमारे साथ ही रहिए, और परिक्रमा के वक्त किसी प्रकार की भौतिक जो बातें हैं जिनसे हमारे कोई लेना देना नहीं, वो कोई करना नहीं है। हमने जो 2-3 दिनों में किया है उसी तरह से हमारा मन और ये सब रखते हुए, भगवान का चिंतन रखते हुए परिक्रमा करो। परिक्रमा आप थोड़े हम आगे जाएंगे तो गोवर्धन तुरंत दिखेंगे, अभी गोवर्धन दिख नहीं रहे क्योंकि वो पुलित्य मुनि के जो श्राप लगे हुए तो धीरे धीरे नीचे धसते जा रहे, धसते नहीं जा रहे ऊपर से, कम आ रहे, जो भी हो रहा है हमारी दृष्टि से। वास्तविक रूप में ये हमने जो कल बरसाना में ये जो चर्चा की थी कि हम जब गोलोक वृंदावन जब भी आप जाएंगे, जब कभी इच्छा तो है कि इसी जन्म चले जाए, इसी बस आखिरी जन्म हो, तो हम वहाँ जाएंगे तो गोवर्धन कोई अलग रूप में नहीं दिखने वाले,
बिल्कुल इसी प्रकार से देखेंगे, बिल्कुल कुसुम सरोवर यही होगा, उसको लगकर ही उद्धव का मंदिर होगा, उसको लगकर ही सारे जो कुंड और वन हम देखेंगे उसी तरह से बिल्कुल। तो ये जो लीला स्थली है कभी खंडन होते नहीं इनका, तो वो चिंतन करते हुए यहाँ पर भगवान नित्य रूप से आज भी चलते हैं और लीलाएं करते हैं। यहाँ कई कई शिलाएं हैं जहाँ पर भगवान के हाथ के चिन्ह है, पैर के चिन्ह है, अगर हमें समय मिला तो कर पाएंगे, देख पाएंगे वो सब। नहीं हो तो आपको कोई बातचीत नहीं करनी है, प्रभुपाद जी की कृपा के द्वारा हमारे पास एक सबके गले में एक थैली लगा दी गई है, यही हमारा धन है। तो जिस तरह से धनिक व्यक्ति पैसे का हमेशा गिनती करते रहता है, वैसे हमको हमारा पैसा ये है, ये हाथ अंदर डाल के मुंह से हम क्या बोलेंगे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे।
जिंदगी में दोबारा कार्तिक के महीने में कब ऐसा मौका मिलेगा वो पता नहीं, तो ये समय जाने मत दो। बाकी सारी बातें शहरों में होती रहेगी, यहाँ आप जो चार पांच दिन आए हैं केवल इसी पर ध्यान और केंद्रित रखते हुए, डोंट अलाउ योर सेल्फ टू बी डिस्ट्रैक्टेड बाय एनी टॉक्स बाय समवन एल्स, इवन विद इन डिवोटीज और आउटसाइड द एसोसिएशन ऑफ डिवोटीज। और छोटी छोटी बातों के वजह से अपना मन बिगाड़ना मत, क्योंकि यहाँ पर एक ही दिन के लिए आए हैं। परिक्रमा करते करते जहाँ जहाँ जगह आएंगी वहाँ अपने आप सही समय पर आपको ब्रेकफास्ट लंच सब मिल जाएगा, आप चिंता मत कीजिए। गोवर्धन जी की कृपा प्रचुर मात्रा में है। तो यहाँ पर आप सब लोग जहाँ पर डुबकी नहीं लगाना है किसको, हम लोग तीन बूंद पानी सिर पे लगाइए, आचमन कीजिए और हम चलते रहेंगे। परिक्रमा सबसे पहले हम दंडवत करके शुरू करेंगे, साष्टांग दंडवत करके, जो पुरुष है वो साष्टांग दंडवत करके, और फिर हम चलना शुरू करेंगे और शाम तक हम यहाँ पहुँचेंगे, ऐसा हमारी इच्छा है।